Hello friends, I'm Gaurav here, and today in this video I'm going to show you how to create LAN file sharing server between Linux and Windows. So here you can clearly see in my lappy I've installed Windows, and in my desktop I've installed Linux. So we are going to make a LAN server between this Windows and Linux using Samba, but I've made this procedure very easy for you. So it is very easy to create LAN between both these operating systems. So first of all, you will need a LAN cable. I have already connected my system, both the systems, with the LAN cable. So now we are going to start with creating the LAN. So let us start. So guys, in my lappy I have installed Windows 7, but this method will work with Windows 7, 8 or 10. This is method is 100% working. Just right click on your computer and just go to properties, and here go to advanced system settings. Here you will find computer name. So I have put my computer name to Windows. You can keep any name. I have put Windows because to identify the server in the Linux system, but you can name it any one. And here there must be work group. If it is home group or another group, change this to work group. It must be in work group. To change to work group, just click on change. Here you can see work group, just name it work group, and to change your window computer name you can change it from here. So okay guys, so now open go to search panel and type there network and sharing. Here you can see network and sharing center. After opening this network and sharing center, you will find here connections in connection section, local area connections, or you can find Ethernet also. Now just double click on this local area connection. Now go to properties. Now click on IP4, which internet protocol version 4. It will by default it will be on obtain an IP address automatically. First go to the use the following IP address, and then just type a IP address. You can type as same as mine also. And this subnet mask is generated by default. So guys, remember both these codes. We have to type in Linux system also. Now just click on OK. Now again open that network and sharing option, network and sharing center, and now go to change advanced sharing settings. On the left column you will find it, and from here you do turn on network discovery. First of all, turn on this system thing, network discovery, and for if you have connected, you want to connect with file printers or file sharing, so just turn on this, turn on file and printer sharing. Next is this thing, public folder sharing. Turn on this also, turn on sharing, so anyone with network extension can read and write in public folders. We are just for learning purpose, we are creating LAN, so there is no problem of security problem. And next we have here you can see password protected sharing. So turn off the password protecting sharing because we are doing it for learning purpose. So just do turn on password protected sharing and save it. Save, click on save changes. Okay, I've already created that system. So So guys, this is my Linux PC in which I have installed Linux Ubuntu 16.10. So for making a file sharing server between Linux and Windows, we need to install a software called Samba. So we are now going to install Samba. Go to search for your computer and type their terminal and open terminal. I have put my this desktop name, Linux desktop name, as Linux, for it will be easy for us for it to identify the Linux PC. Now type a command sudo su and type your password. Now just type another command apt get update and press enter, and make sure that you are connected to the internet, because this apt.get update will update your software center. And now type another command, which is apt get install Samba, and then press enter. Guys, I have installed it already. So here you can see Samba is already in the newest version. But the commands are follow these commands: sudo su apt get update, and then apt get install to completely install Samba, and then type exit. Now go to the right top of your PC, and here you will find edit connections. I just click on edit connections and click on add, and choose the net connection type, and that choose ethernet, and then click on create. Then go to IPv4 settings, then choose the method as manual, and then just click on add and type the following IP address, which is 192.168.43.2, and the net mask is 255.255.255.0, and just check that requires IP4 section and save it. And now here you can see connection established. Now just create a new folder and name the new folder as Linux file sharing. You can name it any thing, any name, give it any name. Now just right click on it and then click on local network share. Now just check that share this folder. And now just give allow access to create and delete files, and allow access to the guest users also. And now just click on create share and just click on add the permissions automatically. So here your is been created, and here you can see that icon has been changed to the forward direction and backward direction. Here you can see it's a symbol icon for sharing shared folder. Now again go to that search and type there gedit, or open any text editor, and I'm going to type in command a message which is hello Windows user, and save it. I'm going to save it in that folder, Linux file sharing folder, which is shared. Now just save it and open it, then you will find that folder. I'm going to rename it as Gaurav, which will be easy for us to identify in the Windows PC. And the message is hello Windows user. So now we are going to fall back to our Windows PC. Before that, again open terminal and just restart your system. We need to restart this Linux PC and this Windows PC both. Now just restart your Windows PC also. So after restarting your Linux PC and Windows PC, go to network. So here you can clearly see Linux desktop. I have named my that Linux desktop name as Linux. So here you can see Linux desktop, it's showing. If you are unable to see that this network PC icon, then just type, press Windows key and Windows plus R key together, or here you will find run. Search for run, you will find easily. Then type the IP address. Type the IP address, then click OK. So here you can see Linux. We have created a folder in Linux which was Linux file sharing. Double click on it and click on it again. We have created a text file. Open it with Notepad. So here you can see Hello Windows User, which we wrote in the Linux text editor. So we have created the file sharing between Linux and Windows successfully. Now I'm going to make a new for sharing Windows files to Linux. So first of all, create a new folder. I'm going to name it Win File Sharing folder name. Okay. Now click on right click on it. Click on properties. Click on sharing. Go to advanced sharing, click on share this folder, full control. Okay, now go to security and click on edit, then just click on add, then go to advanced, then here click on find now, and here you will find a name, RDN name, which is everyone. Just click on OK, give it full control. Here you can just give all the permissions, change permissions also. For our learning purpose, I'm just creating, giving it full control. So this folder is now on share. So I'm going to create a new text file in it. And I'm going to type Hello Linux User. The file name is new text document in Windows, and I've named it Hello Linux Users. Okay, in Windows Win File Share. Now just refresh it, and now we will just move on to our Linux PC. So guys, we are now going to check the Windows file sharing. Go to my files and go to other locations. Here you will find Windows network and both the PCs, Windows desktop, and here you can see Windows PC, and just type a default password 123 or anything you can type, it will work. Because we have turned off that password protection in the network and sharing option in Windows. So here you can see at that last folder, which is Win File Sharing, we have created in Windows File Sharing. Just open it, and here's a new text document which we created in Windows. Here you can see Hello Linux User, which comment we gave in our Windows PC. So thank you guys for watching this video. Do like this video and subscribe my channel for more tutorials. Thank you guys for watching.